إن الحمد لله نحمده ونستعينه ونستغفره ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا ومن سيئات أعمالنا من يهده الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمدًا عبده ورسوله يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله حق تقاته ولا تموتن إلا وأنتم مسلمون يا أيها الناس اتقوا ربكم الذي خلقكم من نفس واحدة وخلق منها زوجها وبث منهما رجالا كثيرا ونساء واتقوا الله الذي تساءلون به والأرحام إن الله كان عليكم رقيبا يا أيها الذين آمنوا اتقوا الله وقولوا قولا سديدا يصلح لكم أعمالكم ويغفر لكم ذنوبكم ومن يطع الله ورسوله فقد فاز فوزا عظيما أما بعد فإن خير الحديث كتاب الله وخير الهدى هدى محمد صلى الله عليه وسلم وشر الأمور محدثاتها وكل محدثة بدعة وكل بدعة ضلالة وكل ضلالة في النار. After praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and sending peace and blessings upon his final messenger Muhammad صلى الله عليه وسلم, my dearly respected brothers, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala throughout his glorious word, the Quran, and in the sunnah of his messenger Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, has revealed a number of promises that he has made. And as we know, as Allah azza wa jal says about himself, that if Allah makes a promise, he never breaks that promise. And the promises which Allah Azza wa Jal makes, he fulfills. And we believe in this with certainty. And we do not only believe in it because we are Muslims and obligated to believe that Allah fulfills his promises, but we also believe in it because we witness constantly the promises of Allah Azza wa Jal being fulfilled. One of the promises that Allah Azza wa Jal has made in the Quran, with the current events that we witness in certain parts of the world like France and whatever else, is the promise that the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will always and forever be high in honor. Allah Azza wa Jal in the Quran, he says to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, وَرَفَعْنَا لَكَ ذِكْرَكَ, and we have made your fame, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, high and exalted. And this is a promise from Allah Azza wa Jal. And we witness this promise from Allah from when the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was sent until the Day of Judgment, it will continue. That Allah has raised his fame and raised his honor. And we see this when we witness the enemies of Islam frequently and constantly putting their wealth and their efforts and their time to try to defame and mock our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, but they will always and continue to fail. No matter how hard they try, Islam is triumph, and it continues to blossom like the flower that it is. And people continue entering Islam and embracing Islam, no matter what the plot of the enemies, is and takes place. Why? Because it is a promise from Allah that the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his honor will always remain on him. Another promise that Allah azza wa jal made to our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, which is also relevant, is the promise that Allah will protect him from the people. Allah azza wa jal, in the time of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam had enemies, and he had enemies from the beginning, because it is the nature of man to oppose the truth, except for the believers who Allah chooses. This is something astonishing about mankind. Mankind in his nature, except for the believers, he does not like the truth. He does not like good. He prefers evil over good. And that's why the prophets and the messengers were constantly opposed by their people, for no other reason than calling to good manners and good morals and good character, and to the worship of Allah Azza wa Jal alone. Our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was sent to some of the harshest and most ruthless of people, who lacked in manners and morals and etiquette and whatever else. And he came to them with manners and morals and etiquette, and they did not like it. And this is the nature of man up until today. Man is known to not want the truth and to oppose the truth, except for who Allah bestows his blessings upon them. For our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, it is not something new that he has his share of enemies, just like his previous brothers from the prophets and the messengers. And because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, in his time, he had the enemy plotting against him, it was only natural that he had some security with him to help in his protection against the plots of the enemy. And this continued until Allah Azza wa Jal revealed the verse, which was another promise from Allah to the Prophet. What did Allah say to him? Wallahu ya'simuka minan nas. Allah will protect you from the people. This is a promise from Allah Azza wa Jal. And this protection is not only his physical protection when he was alive. No. This protection from Allah continues until the Day of Judgment. That the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is protected. His religion is protected. His message is protected. What he came with is protected by Allah Azza wa Jalla. And when those verses were revealed, as Aisha radiallahu anha said, the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam stuck his head out of the window of his house to the masjid, and he said to the people that were guiding him, leave, Allah has protected me. This is the reality of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And the truth is, my brothers, when we witness the mashayikh and the ulama and the Muslims speaking in defense of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam towards what the foolish are doing, do not ever think that this is done because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam needs it. No. The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is not in need of our defense. Allah has already honored him and protected him, as the verses indicate. But as our scholars have mentioned, it is not him that is in need of our defense, but we are the ones in need of defending him. We are the ones in need of him. Why? Because your jealousy and your defending of Rasulullah is a sign of life in your heart. It is a sign of love from you towards your Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. But the truth is, whether we do it or we do not, Allah has already looked after him and has protected him. And that is why the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam was and is the messenger of Allah to all of mankind. As he mentioned himself in the hadith, he said, I was given 6 things that no one else was given. No other prophet was given besides me. One of those things, he said, every prophet was sent to his nation, but I was sent to mankind entirely. For subhanAllah, our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, just like the previous prophet, he came with the good. The worship of Allah Azza wa Jal alone and teaching people to stay away from evil actions. But they did not like it. And they continue not to like it. So they make attempts in mocking him, when in reality they harm no one but themselves. Because the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam is honored by Allah Azza wa Jal. And no matter what they try, he sallallahu alaihi wasallam will always be the leader of mankind. He said it in the hadith in Bukhari and Muslim. He said, "Ana sayyidu waladi Adam yawm al-qiyamah." I am the leader of mankind on the day of resurrection. And I am the first who will be resurrected out of the grave. And I am the first who will intercede. And I am the first whose intercession will be accepted. For no matter what they try and what they plot, you can never defame or dishonor or ridicule someone who has been honored by Allah Azza wa Jalla, especially the greatest of mankind. The heavens itself honors Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So how can men think that they can take this honor away from him? The Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that on the day of judgment, I will come to the gates of Jannah with my ummah and I will seek for its opening. Meaning I will knock on the doors of paradise and the gatekeeper of Jannah will ask, who are you? And the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam says, so I will reply, I am Muhammad. So the gatekeeper of Jannah, what does he say? He says, it was for you that I was commanded not to open these gates for anyone before you. This is how the heavens have honored Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So any attempt by the foolish and ignorant to try to defame him will always be a fail, as it has been proven in history and will continue until the day of judgment. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله لي ولكم ولسائر المسلمين من كل ذنب فاستغفروا إنه هو الغفور الرحيم. الحمد لله وحده والصلاة والسلام على من لا نبي بعده وعلى آله وصحبه ومن سن بسنته وصار على نهجه بإحسان إلى يوم الدين وسلم تسليما كثيرا أما بعد. My dear brothers, Allah Azza wa Jal sent signs of the prophethood of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam in order for those who had doubt to be convinced that he is the messenger of Allah, and the guidance is in the hands of Allah. He guides whom he wills, and he misguides whomever he wills. But Allah gave signs indicating the truthfulness of our Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. And that is why anyone who looks into Islam with a sincere heart will have no choice but to acknowledge that Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is the messenger of Allah. From those signs is the blessings that were in his hands regarding food and drink and whatever else. As Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu said, we were with the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in a travel, and the water with us was very little. So the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam asked for some of the water, and they came with a container of water. He placed his hand in it, and he said, come to the pure blessed water, and the blessing is from Allah. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud said, I witnessed the water flowing from between his fingers. This was the barakah of our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, one of many indications and signs that Allah azza wa jal sent him as a messenger of Allah. And from all the signs that Allah gave the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, the greatest of them was the Qur'an. There is no doubt about this. The Qur'an was the greatest miracle given to our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam because of its perfection. Its perfection in its laws and morals and etiquettes. And that is why Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He put a simple challenge to mankind. Those who deny. And Allah Azza wa Jal says, وَإِن كُنْتُمْ فِي رَيْبٍ مِّمَّا نَزَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ عَبْدِنَا فَأْتُوا بِصُورَةٍ مِّن مِثْلِهِ وَادْعُوا شُهَدَاءَكُمْ مِن دُونِ اللَّهِ إِن كُنْتُمْ صَادِقِينَ. Allah Azza wa Jal says, if you are in doubt regarding what we have sent down to our servant, if you doubt this Quran, then bring one surah similar to it. Just one surah. Bring one surah and then call your witnesses besides Allah if you are indeed truthful. Then Allah says, and if you cannot, and you will never be able to. He makes that promise that they will never be able to bring even a surah similar to this glorious Quran. And that's why Imam al-Tabari rahimahullah, he said, and from the miracles of Allah for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is that the entire creation with all its wealth and all its power and all its help were not able to bring a surah like the Quran. This is from the miracles of Allah azza wa jalla. And finally, my dear brothers, from the signs of his prophethood is the fact that he was prophesied in the previous books as the Prophet Isa alayhi salam and others mentioned of the Prophet who was coming by the name of Ahmad, which is our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So his message has been mentioned in their books, but it is nothing other than pride and arrogance which turns them away from the truth. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to increase our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in honor. We ask Allah Azza wa Jal to ease the affairs of the Muslims worldwide. We ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to allow us to follow him and obey him the way that he deserves. اللهم اغفر للمسلمين والمسلمات المؤمنين والمؤمنات الأحياء منهم والأموات إنك ربنا قريب مجيب للدعوات ربنا آتنا في الدنيا حسنة وفي الآخرة حسنة وقنا عذاب النار إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون فاذكروا الله العظيم يذكركم واشكروه على نعمه يزدكم ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون.